I've been running since 1969, 40 years now. In the early days, we all ran for ourselves. We would run to try to get a faster time, and that's what we were focused on. It was very much a sport in that sense. There was no community outreach like now. Here at the marathon, we're going to have thousands and thousands of people running for charities.
Shoe for Africa, in its base, is an organization that uses sport to empower women and children through the sport of running. So Shoe for Africa traditionally has been collecting shoes and taking them to Africa and then using the events of running as a way to bring people together and educate and raise awareness for HIV and different educational opportunities.
My foundation is the Boomer Esiason Foundation for Cystic Fibrosis that was established back in 1993 when my son Gunnar was diagnosed with the disease at the age of 2. And since that time, our foundation has raised in excess of $75 million. And we put that money in a lot of different places. Most notably, it's in research for new drugs and hopefully to find a cure.
I represent Team for Kids, which is the official charity of New York Roadrunners. Team for Kids are adults who run the ING New York City Marathon and other great races and raise money on behalf of New York Roadrunners youth programs.
Without Team for Kids, there is no youth programs. Thanks to Team for Kids and all the money they raise and the effort that they put to their running, especially for the ING New York City Marathon, we have kids out there running, walking, and having a healthier life.
We were founded in 1988 to meet the needs of homeless people who are living with HIV and AIDS in New York City. And we provide each year housing, healthcare, and prevention services to over 6,000 individuals and families. And we perform about 4,000 HIV tests annually.
Fred's team is the namesake of Fred LeBeau, who was one of the presidents of the New York Roadrunners and is also a co-founder of the New York City Marathon. And the team was founded in 1991 after Fred had become a patient at Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center. And the team was founded to initially direct funds, donations towards pediatric cancer research at Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center.
The Hole-in-the-Wall Gang Camp was founded by Paul Newman in 1988 to provide children with serious illnesses and conditions a free-of-charge camp experience that provides them with empowerment and a new sense of their outlook on the world.
I went to camp at 11 and I was very sick and scared and I didn't really understand what was happening to me, and I left camp a completely new person.
My name's Rachael Plutzik. I'm 16. The charity is Zara Center, which is a community center in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe, for children impacted by AIDS. And Zara Center is a place that provides food, clothing, homework help, and just a safe place to come after school for a lot of these children.
It's actually our mission to help abused, homeless children, at-risk children, and we do this through art and art projects, and we have found that this often is life-changing for them. And we're so proud of what we do, and we're so happy to be able to work with the ING New York City Marathon and get our message out to New Yorkers and to people around the world.
Running programs not only help kids get more physically fit, it also helps build character in kids. Setting goals, working hard to achieve those goals is a great way to uplift oneself as a person.
Since 2002, over 5,000 team members have come out to participate in the ING New York City Marathon to raise over $14 million so that over 100,000 kids can participate in our physical fitness and health education programs.
We see many benefits through this partnership with the ING New York City Marathon. It's allowed us to form new partnerships with community leaders, with residents and business owners in the Harlem community, so that we can raise awareness about the HIV epidemic and create hope for a solution.
The New York City Marathon shares our common goal of having an impact in the world, and we hope to bring light to a cause that we find really important through this event.
Going through all five boroughs, different communities, different ethnic areas, these are exactly the people we serve.
New York City is a center for the world in a lot of different ways, and that's why I think the New York City Marathon is so popular. People want to come here and be a part of this great city, For us, it's a great place to bring the message of what we're doing with Shoe for Africa, because so many different cultures and people come together.
Our goals in this marathon is to get our mission and what we do out to our volunteers or our sponsors, to New Yorkers, and to people around the world.
What started with one runner in 2005, this year we'll have 230 runners raising $750,000 for the hole-in-the-wall camps.
This year we'll have over 100 participants running for our program called Team Boomer. And the ING New York City Marathon will probably raise us in excess of $300,000.
What we're doing here goes beyond sport. It goes beyond running. We're really seeking to transform lives. And running's our vehicle. Through our charity partner program, we are able to help charities raise money, raise awareness for a variety of really important causes. It's a tremendous celebration of people coming together and individuals pushing themselves for the benefit of charity. The Marathon Party is just one day that's part of a year-round initiative. At New York Roadrunners, 365 days a year, we are mission-driven to change people's lives for the better and really improve this world through running. It's a beautiful